Hello, everybody. So glad to see so many friends and sort of fellow Norfers in the audience. I'm really excited to be playing tonight for everybody. And just wanted to say a couple of quick words about Nief-Norf before I get started. So for those of you who aren't familiar with Nief-Norf, we are a contemporary music presenting organization. And that includes performances, summer festival, and sort of year-round concert presentations, including this series, the Virtual Norf Space. And if you are so inclined, please consider making a contribution to Nief-Norf. Right now is a particularly tough time for performing arts organizations, and of course, the summer festival sadly will be canceled this year, and along with several performances that were in the books. So any little bit that you can give in support would be greatly appreciated. In just a minute here, I'm going to play a brand new piece that I've been working on for a while now. It's called Charcoal, and it's about 35 minutes long, and it's a piece for electric guitar and effects. And over the last several years, I've collected and sort of refined my pedal collection, and it's become a living and breathing musical instrument in and of itself. So this piece in particular explores a variety of textures and manipulations of the guitar as to create sort of a larger interactive sort of sound. And so the electric guitar becomes almost like a musical input and sort of electronic controller for the sound, and then the pedalboard itself is like a secondary level with a variety of expressive controls that I am sort of mixing and interacting with in live time. So without further ado, I'm just going to get a few things set up, and then I hope you enjoy the world premiere. Thank you. Thank you. So I hope you enjoyed that. That was a lot of fun to do. And I will be doing, I think, more and more of this in this vein. It's sort of endless inspiration. It's kind of like the perfect thing at the moment when rehearsals are difficult and, you know, impossible. And there's the feedback and the interaction with the pedal board can take the place of collaborating with other musicians. So it's really fun. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. Stick around. We're going to do like a Q&A. If you have any questions about what I just did or, you know, Nief-Norf in general, just put them in the comment section and I will be answer. Okay, so I got one question. To talk a little bit about the pedals. So the pedal board is an array of effects, but they kind of fall into a few select categories, and I actually have multiples of a particular effect. The things that I have the most of are gain, so various levels of distortion. I have some, I'm lucky enough, distortion pedals, including like a very good Klon clone, the Analog Man King of Tone, and the Trace Bliss Brothers analog gauge stage, which actually has sort of two independent gain stages built into it. So I have, between those pedals, I have multiple levels of distortion. And so one thing that distortion does, in addition to making the sort of, you know, sort of traditional electric guitar sound, it sort of compresses and exaggerates the overtones. So one thing that I work with, you know, throughout that, that piece is getting the overtones and the sort of upper partials just by sort of stacking like multiple layers of distortion on top of each other. The other stuff that I have on there, I have three different delay pedals. I have analog delay, is a like most analog things, has like a particularly sort of warm and living and breathing quality. And I have the Strymon Timeline, which is a very sophisticated digital well, that does a lot of really great sort of unusual effects. So one thing that I use quite a bit in that particular piece was a reverse octave up delay, which as you imagine plays the sound backwards and up an octave, and it, which is really great. I could just do that for hours with like harmonics, and then getting those harmonics and the sort of upper fluttery quality. And I have the Eventide H9, which is, among many other things, is a delay pedal, and that pedal also extremely versatile. One effect that I used in there was a delay with a perfect fifth, transposition up. So there was a section in the middle that kind of sounded like Steve Reich, and in that section I'm using sort of perfect fifth up to sort of create a secondary counter with the live guitar. And then the other thing that I have multiples of is reverb. I have one sort of towards the beginning, called the Afterneath, which many bells and whistles, which I didn't actually use much of today, and one at the very end of the signal chain, which is the new neighbor Immerse. And the final reverb in the chain I use stereo. So one thing that I'm using in the room is I have an amp next to me, and with the stereo reverb, I don't know how much of that comes across through the live stream, but when you're in the room, it feels like it takes on a third and fourth dimension. So I could talk on and on about it's become a living and breathing organism, and it's endless hours of amusement. There's a question from Jeremy. And Jeremy is asking about the significance of the title. Well, that is one of these cases where of coming up with a name sort of after the musical material is already sort of developed. And it's really just, you know, I think one of the things about the type of sort of sonic environment that you can get out of the, you know, live effects is it really creates like a soundscape, and you're sort of immersed in that soundscape. And in particular, like some of the grittier very beginning and some of the stuff with like the very high harmonics and tremolo effects and the color that seems to evoke, it was like a dark gray charcoal. So I'm actually imagining a series of pieces that may take that as a springboard for developing musical material, and not in any sort of like straightforward way, but maybe just creating sort of those kind of environments that almost have a visual component and might imply a color. Do we have any more questions? Andrea is asking about the sound that I got at the beginning. It was one of my favorite sounds. And that is the combination of like multiple levels of gain, multiple layers of reverb, and I'm bowing with the handle of a wrench. And I'm bowing on the sixth string, and I'm isolating the like harmonic nodes on the sixth string. So I'm mostly sort of focusing on that sort of one particular pitch, which is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th partial. And but then sort of moving around in that partial and creating sort of those upper like very high singing overtones, along with this sort of like subtle dissonance of the sort of fundamental pitch underneath it. And then of course processing that through tons of reverb and distortion to get that gritty sort of charcoal effect. Question 4, Chris Sterrett plans for releasing this composition. Nothing concrete, but thanks for asking. I solo, you know, recordings while I'm sort of continue to be in lockdown. So that is definitely something that I'm very happy to do. So nothing concrete, but stay in touch. I'll let you know. Jeremy is asking, how did I notate the piece? So it's mostly not notated. It's sort of a collection of ideas, I think, sort of performers that that work in this sort of like gray area between structured and semi-improvised music, especially with anything with like an electronic component. They're all ideas that I've honed and narrowed down, but there's a definite element of improvisation in the sense that you know, each time I perform the piece or rehearse the piece, sections can stretch out and there's a great deal of flexibility. The score, such it is, basically a like technical note as a reminder. So it's all fits on a, you know, 35 minutes all fits on a piece of paper like that. But basically that's just reminding myself pedal settings and stuff. But I'd say set would be more or less the same from one performance to another. But hey, Jeremy. Hey, Jeremy. And nice to see you there. Dave S.
I think it's Dave
Steinbeck. Okay. If that's Dave Steinbeck, hey, Dave. Will you put it on SoundCloud? Sure. Yeah, I'll put it up. I mean, it's going to continue to exist, I assume, on the Nief-Norf YouTube page as a live performance. Please remember to subscribe to Nief-Norf. And we're doing things weekly as well as putting up, archival videos from the summer festival and different performances. So make sure you subscribe. You'll see all of the great stuff that Nief-Norf is doing these days. And one more time, I just wanted to, if you're so inclined, to ask you to please support Nief-Norf. If you are able to make a donation, we would really appreciate it. Like I said, it's a particularly difficult time for performing arts organizations, so any little bit that you could give would be very much appreciated. So with that, I think I will say goodnight. Thanks everybody for tuning in, and I hope to see you all soon. Thank you.